Well, hello. I'm Terry, and I'm a nerd. Welcome to my channel. You know, I love video games, but recently, the industry's been pissing me off. Games today have a lot of hype, but they're wasted by greed. They can be incomplete, full of bugs, and not to mention, microtransactions. 10 years ago, releasing a game that did not work properly was just unthinkable. But here we are, and I'm increasingly disillusioned. So then I thought, why waste my money on all these greedy companies when I already have a whole bunch of classics that I haven't played in years? So many games just waiting to be re-experienced. Are the games as good as I remember them? How do they hold up today? Well, this is not my purpose. To replay the classics of my youth and review them from a modern perspective. So sit back. I hope you enjoy the ride. So, in case I haven't made it obvious enough in the intro or the title of this video, the game we're playing today is Need for Speed Underground 2. I'll be honest, I was never much of a racing game enthusiast. The only game I had besides this one was this, Burnout Revenge. Also a good game, but as you can see, if I only had two racing games, I wasn't that much of a fan. But I did love this game. And this being a channel about nostalgia, it was surprising to me to find how often Need for Speed was showing up in 2000's mean kid starter pack thing. There's been many Need for Speed games, and even more racing games as a whole. So why is this one that keeps showing up? I don't really know, and it doesn't matter. The point is, it's created a lot of good memories for a lot of us as kids. I played this with my brother, and even my father, who wasn't a gamer at all, played this game quite a lot, even beating it. So, enough said. Let's try this.
EA Games.
Salut, c'est Brooke Burke. J'interprète Rachel Taylor dans Need for Speed Underground 2.
Forgot to mention, for the sake of authenticity, I'm playing my actual copy, which is in French, so if you've been wondering about my shitty accent, now you know why. Doesn't matter though, it's not like the game has a whole lot of intrigue, so we can just skip. I remember being pretty amazed by this intro as a kid. The quality now seems a little bit off, but for 2004 it's pretty good. Okay, I'll be honest, I don't know anything about Snoop Dogg, apart from this song and the other from all the memes, but I still feel very confident saying that none of what he did compares to this. Nothing beats this, just nothing. Okay, so let's play the game. Create a profile, there you go. You could actually play the game online, but I doubt it's still supported. And besides, I've always been more of a single player myself. We can just customize a car, so let's see if I remember how. I find it's coming back to me very naturally. The interface is clean and simple, as it should be. Let's put some color, pimp up the car. There you go, that'll work. Let's do a race.
Oh, I'm basically just using the arrows here. It's very straightforward, only playing with one hand. So far, the music is what's really taking me back. The soundtrack in this game had some great selections. The racing, though, well, it's racing. There are many types of races we can try, but let's see them gradually as we go into career mode, what this game really is about. For me, this is the first game I played that used the comic book format for cutscenes, and it did it fairly well. But again, there isn't much going on in terms of story, so let's skip.
Moi c'est Rachel, la copine de Samantha. Il paraît que tu viens d'atterrir ici. Alors, bienvenue à Bayview.
Okay, so Rachel wants us to drive the car back to her. Now, it doesn't matter how long it's been since you played the game, if you've had more than one career, you know that there are a bunch of races you can do before you bring the car back, and it actually really pisses her off, so let's do that. Honestly, although her car is fast and pretty badass, it actually kinda sucks. It drifts like crazy and just spins in circles at the slightest turn. Okay, so I did the races, let's bring the car back.
Ah, quand même! T'étais où avec ma caisse?
Since you can't understand anything and it doesn't really matter, I gotta share a fun fact. The character of Rachel is voiced by Brooke Burke. If you don't know anything about Brooke Burke, let me show you something. Rachel wasn't some random character just drawn for the purpose of the game. No, this is Brooke Burke.
Hey, watch for me, Brooke Burke, this fall in the new Need for Speed Underground 2 from EA Games. I mean, fast cars, beautiful girls, adrenaline. I mean, I think this is a game that anyone can enjoy.
Rachel was very much real. Our crush was real.
Ready for some serious driving?
After giving away the car, it's time to get our own from a wide variety of, honestly, shitty models. After it's done, this is where the full Need for Speed Underground 2 experience really begins. The game features an open world, which was new to this series. Looking at it now, the graphics have aged fairly well. The town itself looks like a mix of Las Vegas, Miami, and Beverly Hills. At this point, the game is simple. Make money by winning races. Use the money to upgrade your car's mechanics and appearance. As you win races, you'll get sponsors who give you extra money for specific races, photographers who want to put your car on magazines and DVDs, and you'll gradually unlock new car parts. The races are in the city, so looking at the map, it explains why there seems to be no structure whatsoever. The streets are all crooked on most of the map. So let's talk about racing. It's racing. Get from point A to point B, be the first to get there, simple as that. There are different types of races. The circuit, classic. The sprint is a race without laps, so it's shorter. So far it's pretty common, but then we have some interesting choices. Drifting is pretty cool until it is very much not. Essentially, you try and drift as cool as you can for the highest score, but the moment you hit anything, you lose the score. Drags are pretty cool if you manage to do them correctly. This is the only part of the game that forces you to drive manual, but it's real intense, possibly my favorite. Street X, though, is the fucking bane of my existence. Very sharp turns is summing it up pretty well. I've learned with this one that if you don't get ahead in the first 20 seconds, you're most likely not going to win at all. As you progress to career mode, you unlock new parts of the map with their own races. You can also get new cars that will make better use of the mechanics upgrade. Overall, this is a pretty fun game. As I've said, I wasn't all that into racing games, so although I find it grindy at times, it may just be that I'm not into racing much. But I did love this game as a kid. Making your ride look awesome was this game's core feature. Everything we do for the car. And as a kid, I would get attached to those rides, and I'd be proud of all the upgrades I'd put into it. Today though, I'm seeing more flaws in the game. Remember what I said about the map? Because every street was designed to be tracks in a race, driving around gets old pretty quick. Especially when you unlock the hills. That place is an absolute pain to drive around. In fact, just driving to the races becomes dull pretty fast. The map is huge and quite ambitious for the time, but there really isn't all that much to do. There aren't any stunts to perform. If you make a jump in a race, it's mostly the result of driving fast up a slope. There are some tips you can collect that no one ever cared about, some money here and there that you can grab. You can also challenge NPCs to duels. It gives you some money, but it's not substantial enough that I would seek those NPCs. So it just goes back to racing. The racing itself is fun. You can make your opponents lose control of their car, you can use Nitro for an extra boost. And generally, the scenery is pleasant. As you progress through the game, you can race at the airport and train tracks. And the music is always a bonus. The music in this game is pretty awesome. I don't really have any songs in this game that I don't like.
I was hoping to finish the game as part of this review, but unfortunately, that did not work. The racing is fun, but as the game progresses, it gets hard.
And I'm a noob, so around the third sponsorship, I started to struggle hard.
While I got to experience some nostalgic fun from winning, I started to experience some nostalgic rage from losing. And being now 24 years old and much more mature, I discovered a power that I didn't have as a kid. I learned to just stop.
Okay, come on, come on, come on. Ah, fuck! Okay, oh, that's a good one, that's a good one. No, 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 no! Shit! Come on, do you see that? Like, do you see the score that you have to reach on this one? Like, I tried to do all drifts, but I just can't do it. And the more pressure I'm under, the more mistakes I make. Come on! Okay, come on, come on. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Yeah, obviously. Okay, here. Okay, look at this, guys. Look at this. I'm short 3,000 points, and the finish line is right there. Okay. Oh, I have an idea. Let's drive back and try drifting again. Ah, sh**. Nah, it doesn't work. He doesn't let me. Once you've progressed, you've progressed. That's it. Ah, sh**. Come on. Ah, this is f**ing ridiculous. Oh, come on. Again? I was so close. Finally. That was rough. Let's do a drag race next. God, why is there so much traffic? Everyone crashed except the winner. Are you serious? Even if I manage not to crash, I can't catch up to that first guy. He's just too damn fast. Why isn't he the one crashing? That's what I want to know. Everyone's crashing but him, so come on, just crash. Come on, come on, come on, crash. Yes, oh! Oh, okay, I'm good. Alright! Finally made it! Outstanding! Well, despite making it through these races, the last straw came for me when I checked my progress and realized I wasn't even halfway through the game. And that's after 20 hours of gameplay. But again, my incompetence was starting to show, I was starting to enjoy the game, and so I stopped.
So, was the game as good as I remembered? Well, despite everything I said, yeah, actually. I remember good-looking graphics, cool-ass cars, some cool racing, and some cool music. I got it all. For the first three quarters, I genuinely enjoyed myself, until I started to suck, essentially. How does it hold up today? When I say that, I don't mean like, how does it compare to like Forza Horizon 4? I just mean like, this being an old game, when you play it, does it feel old? Yes, it does, but it's aged pretty well. The graphics are still pretty good. When I was a kid, I used to play this on my potato PC at 800x600. Now, with a more stronger PC, I could play it at 720p on my 1080p display and increase the settings. Because of that, I ended up realizing the game was actually much better quality than I thought it was. I could see the reflections on the cars of lights and streetlights, and it was pretty cool. And when I used the Nitro, now there's like this blurry effect of going faster that I did not even have as a kid. I did not even know it was real. So it was refreshing, even though it was old. So if you're looking for a race game to play, and you don't want to spend $120 for it, well, maybe give Need for Speed Underground 2 a shot, if you still have it. You should know, though, that there is a remaster that's rumored to release in 2022. So maybe it'll become a huge hit again. And maybe this channel will have something to do with it. Or not. Yet? Thanks for watching, everyone who made it all the way here. This was my first video on this channel. I hope you liked it. I'm hoping to make this my actual career, so if you're into classical gaming, less classic than, say, Nintendo 64 and more like early to mid-2000s, then be sure to subscribe for more content. And please share it around. The more people I get following this channel, the more content I can produce. See you next time. This turned out to be more stressful than I thought, this whole YouTube channel thing. I think the next game, I'm going to need something more peaceful, more chill, you know? Something I can do at my own pace. What the heck is this?